What is up, YouTube? I'm back with another Magicka Nightblade bomb build. Since a QT is not viable anymore as a bomb blade, I swap to War Maiden, which gives almost 580 spell damage. For Nightblades, we have only magic damage abilities, like Zapper Sense or Spammable, our ultimate Soul Tether, and the detonation. Even single target skills like Concealed Weapon or the bow are magic damage. From Bastille Vicious Death with Balorg as monster set. Still full divines, full light armor, so 7 light armor with full max magicka glyphs here. Full infused spell damage on the jewelry. Front bar still 2 swords. Maces would be probably better, but I already had those 2 juicy swords. One in Nirn and one in Sharp. Back bar, just a random healing stuff. I always use the critical riposte here for extra crit resistance, but you can also use something like the Master or Black Rose Prison, doesn't matter to be honest. For the non-CP campaign, you can use Spinners instead of Vicious Death, since we cannot use proc hits over there. Still War Maiden on the body then, with one Balorg and one Scoria, for example, for extra penetration. It also works. I did a couple of non-CP bombs. Of course, it's weaker than the Vicious Death and the Balorg set, but it still works. Skills, nothing has changed here. Still Camouflage Hunter for minor Berserk and extra spell damage thanks to the Slayer passive. Then Concealed Weapon for the 25% extra movement speed while in Sneak. Zapper Sense, our spammable. Merciless Resolve, they changed this one. It doesn't give crit damage anymore. Spell damage each stack. 60 for each stack, so in total 300 spell damage. Shadow Disguise, our cloak ability. Soul Tether, still our ultimate. Back bar, Dapper Magic, a shield. Rapid Regen for healing. Chanted Acceleration for minor force, another 10% crit damage. Shadow Image for mobility. Detonation and a Restoration ultimate here. Raise and still Khajiit for extra 12% crit damage. Still the best bomb raise, I guess. But Dunmer, High Elf are fine too. Asmodeus the Shadow Modus for 17% crit damage with full divines and Ghastly Eyeball. As Buffwood, Iron Vamp for extra spell damage thanks to the passive. Where is it? Over here, Darkstalker and Strike from the Shadows, 300 more spell damage after you left Sneak or Invisibility. Potions, I mainly use the spare power potions or the detection potions, also nice, but then you lose Major Prophecy only if you slot Major Prophecy on the front bar. For example, Camouflage Hunter, you can use those detection potions. CPs, Biting Aura, Master at Arms, Backstabber and Fighting Finesse, Celerity, Boundless Vitality, Rejuvenation and Slippery. Let me show you the bomb rotation really quick. Start with Chain Acceleration and Merciless Resolve. Best case scenario, like here, if you have 5 stacks with Merciless Resolve, you gain 300 more spell damage. Then Detonation, Cloak, and shortly before the detonation explodes, use Soul Tether in combination with Zapper Sense. Now enjoy some decent bombs before the video starts. Don't forget to sub my channel. Over 90% are still not subbed. Do me the favor, click on the red juicy button, leave a like and a comment below. I would really appreciate it, guys. Enjoy. That's it with the PvP build. Thanks for watching, guys. Next one will be probably a range Magikka Knight build. See you in the next video. Ciao.